Today, first of all, I want to introduce Sonu Sood. I know him, but first time I read about so many articles during this crisis. When all labor, migrated labor, they wanted to go to their respective residences or destinations. At the time, there was so much of crisis. I have seen him. He came on roads, how we monitored, and ultimately, what all possible within his limits he has done. Again, I have seen him one more incident in Madanapalli. That incident, even students, daughter and son, wife, they don't have bullocks to plow the land. They used their daughter and family members. It was a very moving situation. Then immediately he came to their rescue. He has done even to give some tractor support like that. And also at that time I spoke to him. I was totally impressed. He's a real human being. Whenever society is in trouble, it is our duty to serve the people. Or otherwise there is no meaning for our money. There is no meaning for our lives. This crisis, COVID, it is not one place. It is a global crisis. It will take some more time to recover also. People had a very, very sad experience. Broken families, miserable families. Economically, they are all very, very problematic. And also this crisis, if you see why I am saying this, frontline warriors, all of you, I really appreciate all of you. You have done extraordinary work. Even relatives are unable to serve the COVID positive patients. At that time, this frontline warriors, either doctors or supporting staff, nurses or police, and also even so many people who helped them, they have done extraordinary service. Because of them, even today, there is a feeling, not only feeling, so many people have saved their lives. I salute all of you. And at the same time, this crisis, if you see, if you leave it to only governments, even some governments we are watching globally. Some governments have done very, very quick. They are able to recover to certain extent. Some of the governments, we are having some problems also. But at the same time, as NGOs or best human beings, what all possible, we have to do our best. I have seen so many crises, but this is never expected, never imagined. I have seen Hudhud in the recent times. One city and 2-3 districts totally destroyed. Within 8 days, we were able to recover totally. Normalcy we were able to establish. Then I started moving from that place. I was in a bus, there is no shelter for me, but we have done. Like that I have seen hurricane, even super cyclone, which crossed Orissa, Bhuvaneshwar. At that time I was CM for United Andhra Pradesh. Never I fixed my boundaries. Immediately I asked my people to move to Orissa. And we saved people. We extend all the support what all possible from government of Andhra Pradesh. And also recently, Titli, Tufan, all these things we handled. Even Uttarakhand floods. we are able to evacuate all victims from there by special flights, and we are able to safely reach them immediately to their respective destinations. These are all various, not only this, these are only few I am mentioning. Like that, we have done so many things. But this crisis COVID, we have to protect ourselves. It is an unknown enemy. We don't know who is having COVID, and we have to protect ourselves. And also we have to protect our families. We have to protect our people. It is a continuous process. Wave one we have seen. Wave one, we had so many miserable stories. From the beginning, what all possible, we have done our best. If you see here, wave one, I had so many meetings with frontline warriors, and we identified some of people. Now, Lokeshwar Rao is here. He is a NRI doctor in America, but he is doing online telemedicine services continuously. But his formula is working. That protocol is working very well. We are very happy about it. Wave one, wave two, wave one, we are able to do some help. Wave two also, we intensified again, free distribution of medicines, oxygen concentrators, telemedicine surveys, and also food supply. All these things, what all possible, we have done our best. All the details, Mr. Vijay has rightly mentioned, we have done. Even very cost-effective model. I'm very happy Lokeshwar Rao has done. Initial stage, first wave, if you see, mask, social distance, and also online working, sanitization, all these things we have promoted. During wave two, we are saying very clearly, this is much more dangerous compared to wave one. So many casualties, and also side effects, and also black fungus, white fungus, yellow fungus, this type of infections. It is much more dangerous and also very pathetic conditions. Even some governments are able to do better, some governments are unable to do. I don't want to comment here. Here, beyond political, we want to act. But ultimately, nobody can replace governments. Even I will do only little bit. Even Sonu, Mr. Sonu will do better than that. But all of us also can do. But government is having absolute powers and resources, either financial resources and powers to acquire medicines and also doctors. Even they can engage emergency services from everybody. All these things are possible. So governments has to play more positive role, but all of us has to supplement as a responsible citizens, and also some NGOs, those who are interested to serve all these things. Ultimately, we had a very bad experience as on today. Not only India, so many countries, for that matter, we had a bad experience. And at the same time, now people are saying there will be third wave also, wave three. We must be careful. For all these things, vaccine, vaccine, vaccine. If you go for vaccine, first vaccine, it will protect us. Second vaccine, it will be more advantage. Even anybody will get COVID positive, even then it will be mild. From home only, they can take treatment. In this wave three, we must be prepared for that. What all possible for everybody? We have to work together. Even I am really appreciating all of you. We had experiences now. wave one, how it has happened, wave two, how it has happened, how it is going to happen, if at all, wave three. There are some discussions also. Originally, vaccine will be given only 60 years and above. Then government has decided 45 and above we have to give vaccine. Meanwhile, COVID had a host of 18 years or 20 years and above also. Some youngsters, 25, 30 years are also died. And also now it is attacking children from 2 years, even not only 2 years, even newborn babies also. That is the scenario today. But one solution for all of us, casualties compared to old people and children below 18 years, it is less. That is only advantage for us. Globally, it has been proved. But ultimately, what all I wanted to request all of you, how to prepare wave three, while acknowledging all your services for wave one, wave two. Now cases are coming down. We don't know when it is going to pick up. Even England, they have given two vaccines, around 60% like their population. Even now, wave three is there, but mild. Even in America and other countries, they are facing same problem. As a country, even government of India has announced even vaccine above 18 years also. Now trials are going on, 2 and 18 years age group also. All these things are going to happen in the near future. But COVID cannot wait all these things. We have to protect, take precautions, and at the same time, we have to go for vaccination. Even after vaccination also, we will become a carriers. I have seen some of the patient people, two vaccines, even then they got it. It is a mild effect, but they are able to cure at home with a little bit expenditure, with some medication, light medication. And some people have died with some other side effects, heart problems, all these things, it is going on. So with all these things, again, to bring normalcy, it is our responsibility. All frontline warriors, you are having so much of experience. You have to give all your experiences for future, how to prevent COVID wave three. I really appreciate Sonu Sood is the best example, is an icon. Whenever there is a need, he won't think even 1 minute. Immediately, he used to respond. That is his nature. I'm very happy for that. By taking him as a spirit, all of us has to work in that direction. Even I am seeing Lokesh Rao from America. He is available 24/7. I really appreciate him. That is his commitment. And also NTR Memorial Trust, they have done very well. Mrs. Bhuvaneswari and also Rajendra Kumar, they have extended all the support. We created one of the best ecosystem. What all possible within our limits in mobilizing funds or spending money, giving oxygen plants. Even he has given so many oxygen plants. Even NTR Memorial Trust sanctioned 6 oxygen plants and all these things we are doing. With this again and again, I am thankful to you on behalf of the society for your extraordinary services. Even I have written letters to all frontline warriors for your service, extraordinary services. Now, one side, we have to take the support of the government, and at the same time, we have to move to protect ourselves against wave three. With this, I'm thanking all of you. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.